Happy birthday, Virgos. I want to say to you, Virgos, happy birthday. All right, Virgos. Amazing, my babies. Okay, so Virgos who were born from, Virgos who were born from 7th September until the 13th, congratulations, happy birthday. It's going to be a good year for the ladies. Whatever is happening and transpiring, Virgo ladies, this year, right after your birthday, is going to be an absolute fabulous, fabulous year. So let's see. You have the energy of the world that is guiding you through this year. This is the energy of the week, and it's also the energy of what you guys are going to be ending a cycle in your life. And this is going to be good. This is going to be very, very positive. You're finally ending a cycle in your life, whatever that was happening and transpiring. You Virgos are taking back your reign. Okay, you were dealing with some sort of issue and situation that was affecting you and your life, and you're taking back your reign. It is a very, very beautiful year for you guys. And once you end this year, you are going to be seeing transition not only in yourself, but in your world. Virgos, it is good to ask for a birthday reading, because what it does with the birthday reading is that you will know what is coming up for you, because a birthday reading is programmed on the person who you are as an individual. It is programmed on you, and each and every month that is coming up in a solar year, because you begin your solar year from 2020. Now is when you begin your 2020 solar year, so you're ending it in 2021. So it's very important for you Virgos to really connect and get an understanding and get heads up where you're going to. Virgos, I love this year for you guys, and we're first going to be doing the general energies, then we're going to be looking at each and every person. Again, how these year readings go, if you notice, I start to like spread them out so that people can understand each and every action that happens for each and every person in each and every day. Is a collective of this year for you. So these are the issues that you're going to be working on. So if you were born on the 10th of September, you're going to be getting in the first month after your birthdays with the energy of the magician, bringing in financial stability, and news is going to be coming in for you. And this is going to be news that is going to be bringing you a lot of stability in your world. So the center, if you were born on the 10th, then you begin with the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th. Then you go back 14, 15, 16, 17. That's how you work the 12 months of your solar year, okay? So then each and every month, you will be programmed and know exactly what is coming up. This is a general reading that is a global reading. It is not programmed directly for each and every person. So you will be affected with these energies that is coming up, okay? I want to say a big, big shout out to all my Virgos fans. I love you guys so much. I don't know. I just love Virgo people. I always get along with Virgo people, and because I'm also a hurt person. But I like the mystery of the Virgos. And not everyone do understand the Virgos, because they're very mysterious, because you're mastered by Mercury, and this is why you and the Geminis are so positive. If you notice, you begin, especially business people, I want you to take the advantage of this year, because business people are going to be doing very, very well, okay? People are going to be seeing truths to a lot of situation, and truths about this person who is the Knight of Wands. Whoever this person is who is the Knight of Wands, I see people are going to be finding out. So some of you could be dealing with a fire sign man, and people are going to be finding out who this person is and what this person have done, and how this person have created some sort of a false light by changing up some sort of a information that was and creating some sort of an issue for you Virgos, and this is going to be coming out and people are going to be seeing what this person has done. So Virgos, your general reading is that the Magician is going to be here helping out, especially a lot of people who are working and doing spiritual work. The Magician is going to be here in order to resolve whatever the issues and situation that you're having. Women, you have a lucky, lucky year. So if you were born between 7th and 13th of September, you're going to be having a very, very lucky year, especially the women. You're going to be incredible because your psychic is going to be so good. And if you're doing spiritual work, you're going to be making a whole lot of money. Then when we look, the Six of Pentacles and the Ace of Cups. So help is going to be coming in financially and your heart is going to be healing. I see you guys are going to be very, very successful. Here we're seeing the Ace of Wands. So there's a lot of new beginnings. New beginnings in love, new beginnings in money. Okay. And then we see another new beginnings. This new beginnings is that you're creating some sort of an issue and situation. I see a lot of you are going to be receiving offers from different corporation institution. A lot of you are going to be climbing the step, climbing the ladder. Okay. Then we are seeing the energy of the Hangman. And I see a lot of you are going to be making a lot of money when it comes on to family business or business on a whole. So business people is going to be making a lot of money. So however this is coming up, you can see that this is a new start in love, success. You're going to be receiving financial help, new start in love, success. Women are going to be getting some sort of a break. Okay, a good break where the Ace of Wands is going to be coming in and the Ten of Wands. And then we're seeing the Ace of Pentacles. And this is going to be absolutely, absolutely fabulous. So wonderful alignment of energies is going to be coming up for you Virgos and Virgo women and men. Take the risk and create wonderful wealth for yourself because it's going to be coming in. So let's go and look at the individual people. So if you were born on the 7th of September, I see some of you could be getting some sort of a promotion, some sort of a push up the ladder. You could be creating a business, and whatever business you're creating, I see you're going to be having the financial support that is going to be coming in. Now, you got to be aware of what is happening and what is transpiring because I see truths are going to be coming in. Things are going to be as if all of a sudden everything is going to be falling in place for a lot of you people who were born on the 7th of September. Whatever this energy is and whatever the transition of this energy is, you're going to be seeing that people are going to be really coming together in order to balance out themselves and balance out a lot of issue. I see you people are going to be standing your grounds and holding your force, dealing with whatever is coming at you. And it's as if I'm not backing down and I'm not stepping down. And this is going to give you a good positive energy because you're going to be creating your wealth and financial stability moving forward. So it's a beautiful, beautiful year. For you Virgos, you could be getting some sort of a help financially to create your business or to invest in your business because people are seeing what you're doing for people and how you're helping people to survive this sort of a period moving forward. So whoever business was down and you were born on the 7th of September, it's going to be getting up. So we're moving on to people who were born on the 8th. Of September, your psychic is going to be off the chart. Whatever is happening and transpiring, your psychic is absolutely going to be off the chart. I see people are going to be offering you love. People are going to be showing up for a lot of you. And people are going to be standing and protect you in whatever way they can. Because people are going to be seeing some sort of injustice or some sort of a gloom and protection that you have that is creating so much prosperity around you but not only for yourself, for other people. If you are psychic or you do psychic work or you do coaching and that sort of a thing, the information, everything is just going to be coming out, and this is going to be attracting more people to you because they realize that you have the answers to what they're looking for. So communication is going to be extremely, extremely good. Your psychic is going to be on top of the game, and you're going to be healing your heart chakra. Whatever the issues, the problem, whatever situation, you're going to be healing your heart chakra, and new love is going to be coming in. This is a powerful, positive year for you. The Eye Princess is going to be guiding a lot of you. So your spirit guides are going to be coming in through the dream time and working with you. So call upon your spirit guides to come in and protect you through this time period, because they're going to be there and they're going to be offering you love and support. We're moving on to the people who were born on the 9th, the Wheel of Fortune. Congratulations. Congratulations. Success is here for you, and a new start is going to be coming up. 333. So the Ascendance Masters, and especially if you're working on the frequency of the Ascendance Masters, they're going to be coming in and helping you. This is a very, very wonderful, wonderful year for you people who were born on the 9th, because the Wheel of Fortune is bringing you success, but it's also giving you a new start moving forward in a powerful new direction. And people are going to be finding out and seeing that you're on your part to success and moving you out of whatever that was transpiring in your world. And you are going to be successful. Whatever you try in this world, in this year, you're going to be very, very successful, you people that was born on the 9th. 3 plus 3 is 6, but 3 times 3 is 9. You get the Wheel of Fortune, and it's as if this is going to be one of your most luckiest year. Every year you get a lucky year, and whoever is born on the 9th of September is going to be receiving this very, very lucky year. Number 3 is going to play a significant role in your life. Make sure that 3 is not your bad lucky number. If it's your lucky number, if it's in your lucky number, 3 is going to be playing a whole lot of significance role in your life. The Ascendant Masters are going to be working with a whole lot of you that was born on the 9th, because being born on the 9th, that means you're a spiritual person. A lot of people are not aware of this. And you can be starseed, and then they're going to be coming in to help you out, okay? Wonderful, wonderful energies. As we look at the people who were born on the 10th, you are going to be helping the rest of the people who were born 7, 8, and 9, 11, 12, and 13. You're going to be helping them. You are setting the trend in this year where you are going to be moving forward in a very positive direction. Now, what we see here is that the energy of the Magician is a wonderful, powerful energy. And you ladies and men and ladies are going to be playing some sort of a significant role. Some of you could be connecting with a Capricorn woman, and this Capricorn woman is going to be helping you to create wealth for you and opening up your awareness, okay? Whoever this Capricorn woman is going to be opening up doors of opportunities for some of you. And this person, if you are looking for a job, is going to be opening up the way for you. If you're looking for a job and you are open for a new job, I see you're going to be opening up the way, and this is going to be just so positive and so powerful. So congratulations to the people who were born on the 10th. You're dealing with 4. And news, a whole lot of news is going to be coming in. And if you have a business, a whole lot of business is going to be coming in to you. And this is going to be absolutely, absolutely fabulous. So congratulations. Then we are looking at the people who were born on the 11th, duality. You're going to be dealing with a lot of people in corporation, institution. You could be running your own business, but this is going to be good because, again, the Ace of Wands is here. So you're going to be receiving some sort of a news from a corporation, institution that is going to be opening up doors of opportunities. So if you were looking for a job, if you wanted to change a job, If you were applying to a huge government institute organization, it is going to be a yes all over, because they are going to be seeing that, yes, you have the potential that we're looking for. And you're going to be, if you have your own business, expect that things are going to be just kicking off the charts, because people are going to be finding you and realizing that you have the power within you to create positive shift of energy in any corporation institution, whether it's your business or you are working. So I see a whole lot of messages going to be coming in from a corporation institution and showing up how you're going to be creating and making changes in the world. So this is beautiful and powerful. You have Ace of One. It's always a one and a seven. One and seven is eight. So there is a sense of unexpected money that is going to be coming in. Infinity abundancy, number eight. So you have to always look under the energies of what is coming out, because the Hierophant is a very, very powerful energy that a lot of people, that mean you're clearing a lot of karmas with people in corporation and institution, and this is going to be good. We are moving on to the people who were born on the 12th. Now, the energy of this year is a cycle is going to be over. And you can see here, because you have the energy of the Hermit. And a lot of you could be just going within, like the whole year. Sometimes you just have a year of spirituality that you go within. You shut yourself off from the world. You could go to work and do all of those things, but yet still, you are so connected with yourself. You shut yourself from the outside world and it's going within in order to find yourself. And through that, you're going to be ending your burdens, and whatever the hardship is, a cycle is going to be coming over. It is hard working on the 12 energies. Okay, 12 and 23 energies are very, these frequency are very hard. And if you were born on the 12th or 23rd of a year or so, these energies are really, really harder because they're transition energies. Okay, so some of you are going to be finding your way, and some of you are going to be showing the way. And you're going to be showed the way through your spirit guides, and you're going to be ending all of the hardship you have been having in your life, and all of the burdens that you have been carrying. Because a lot of you that is born on the 12th have been blocked and in some sort of a frequency. If you notice what is going on, is that through going in meditation, a new road is shown to you. Okay, so sometimes it's good to go in quiet meditation. A new road is showing you the way. And if you notice all the hardship that you have been going through, it is a lesson. And you need to look for what is the lesson in all of this. And some of you are going to be finding out your intuition was guiding you all of the way. But every time you go against your intuition, or you don't listen to your intuition, that is what brought you in some sort of a hardship. And you're overcoming this. And this door, some of you feel as if you're blocked or you're trapped. But the key is right there. And all you have to do is to lift your head, turn around and look at where the key is, and just pick up the key, put it in the door, open it and free yourself. So as you can see here, you have the energy of this diamond shape, the pentacles shape. And it's as if they're saying, look, you are beating up on yourself. You need to release that energy, throw this energy off, and look at what is transpiring. And seeing that all you have to do is pick up the key, open the door, and free yourself from the inner conflicts that you are going through. And as you do that, you are going to be surviving whatever hardships you have been going through, because this cycle is going to over. Then we look, your numbers is going to be 10. 10 is 1. Omega is talking to you, so you're going to be connecting with your spirit guides. Then we see the energy of the Five of Pentacles. And the Five of Pentacles is that you're going to be releasing yourself, because it's as if You're not seeing that there's a light at the end of the tunnel. You're not seeing the key is right behind you. Just turn around and look. You're overlooking things because you have your head down. You need to start looking up, going 360 degree and looking around because you have the key right behind you, okay? Then we are seeing the people who were born on the 13. You have the energy of the Hangman. Another hard energy to work with, 12, 3, 13. Whenever you were born on these days, it's like it's a spiritual days. So it's as if the universe is always beckoning to you that, hey, you're spiritual. Use your gifts in order to create your wealth. And if you use your gifts in order to create your wealth, you're going to be very, very successful because that is your gift that you're using to help humanity and the universe. And what it's going to do is bring miracles because this year is a miraculous year for you people. So people who were born on the 12, you're dealing with the energy of 3, the Ace of Pentacles. A new start is going to come into your financial stability by using your own gifts. It's as if they are pushing you to open up yourself and accept who you are. And by using your own gifts, you're going to be creating your wealth and you're going to be having a very, very new start to your financial stability. And this is going to be good. So a lot of you are going to be ending the year, and especially if you end the 6 months here, you're going to be ending the year creating, using your own energy to create your wealth. So let's say let's look who is going to be ending the year with this energy. So you begin here. So we have 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 months. So the 7 month for whoever begins, who is the 7th of September, the 7th month is going to be your best month, okay? So if you were born the 10th, 11th, so you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10th month is going to be your most prosperity month. So this is how you're going to be looking at to see which days you were born, when does this comes up, okay? And that is how you're going to be realizing, how you're going to be fulfilling your prosperity and which month is your most prosperity month, and this is going to be good. Miracles, call upon Archangel Metatron, with the Empress. This is the energy of a Capricorn. Some of your Capricorn is going to be vital to your success. A Capricorn could be coming up as a lover. So this is going to be good. So whatever is happening and transpiring, I see some of you are going to be dealing with a fire sign person. And I see they're going to be helping you and protecting you from this fire sign person, whoever this person is, and really protecting you. I see people in power are going to be really showing and protecting you from some sort of disadvantage that a fire sign person have done to some of you, okay? Please remember and check out the weekly readings. Go back. The full moon readings is out. Virgos, you have the full moon in September. It's in your sun sign. So whoever is a sun sign Virgo, expect to have a very, very powerful September where things are going to be coming back to normal for you, and a lot of possibilities and doors are going to be opening up. I love you guys. I gotta go. Namaste.